today's episode, we will be cooking collard greens. And for this recipe, of course, we're going to need a bunch of collard greens. I think I have about 5 bunches. You also going to need onions, salt, pepper, onion powder, chopped garlic or regular garlic powder. I'm using some crushed red pepper and some olive oil and the smoked turkey mix. Now, if you don't like smoked turkey mix, you can also use the pork, the smoked pork they have, or the fat back or whatever. So when we come back, we're going to start off by boiling the turkey mix. Okay, I'm back. I already rinsed off the turkey mix and I added some water, and now I'm just going to let it boil on medium high for maybe about an hour so it can flavor this water. And now I'm going to work on cutting the greens and washing the greens and doing all of that. Okay guys, I'm back. Now I'm going to start working on the greens. So I normally cut this part off, the stem, and then I just fold it like this and pull it off because I don't like the stems. Sometimes it's real easy and it'll just come all the way off. And I try not to waste much, but you just keep doing this. Now, if you don't like this way, you don't have to, but I don't like the stem. So I'm going to continue doing this. I'll do a couple of more, but you just fold it down and just tear this off. And with this little baby one. And then I'm going to wash them, rinse them until they clean. In the particular store I go to, they normally come out real. I mean, they already probably clean, but I still wash them myself. Now, if you got it out the garden or something, you'll have to go through and then you pick out anything that's bad. So when I come back, I'll be rinsing them out and washing them in the sink, and then we'll
go. Okay, guys, it's been an hour now, and you see how it looks now. So now I'm finna cut the greens up because I already done washed them off. So now I'm finna come back and then I'm going to show you me cutting the greens.
With me soaking the greens, you just need to keep rinsing them off until you get all the dirt. If it's any dirt on them or any gritty things, sometimes it could be bugs in them. So you just want to soak them and make sure they real clean. So you just keep rinsing them off, soaking them. Sometimes some of these stores now, they be having that little automatic, like a little sprinkle system. They be rinsing them out all day. So these really weren't that dirty. So when I come back, we'll be ready to cut. Guys, now I just picked some out just so I can show to cut them, how to cut them. So I just roll mine up. You can do it however you like, but this is how I do mine. And I just slice it like this. I don't think it's a particular way to slice, but however you like to do it is how you do it. So that's all I do. Then I just reach back in and get some more, and you just roll it up. So let me get a little bit more and just show you some more examples. Okay, this starts to be enough. I just roll it up. And then I put it back. So I'm gonna continue to do this until I got it enough ready that I'm gonna dip them in the pot. I'm back. So I finished chopping them up. So now I'm gonna put them inside the water and I'm cooking this on medium high. Then I'm gonna let it cook down some. And once it cooked down some, then I'm gonna come back and add my seasoning. So I'm going to let it cook down and add my seasoning. So when I come back, I'll be adding the seasoning. Guys,
now I let it cook down some. It's probably been cooking for like 20, 25 minutes. I don't know. But I'm finna add a chicken bouillon cube. I forgot to tell y'all that I use that. Sometime I put chicken broth in here. And this turkey meat is starting to break up. And I'm going to put a teaspoon of pepper. I don't know if that's quite a teaspoon. 2 tablespoons of garlic, chopped garlic. Two tablespoons of onion powder. And I'm going to adjust the seasoning once they cook some more. So if that's not enough, I'll add whatever extra that I might. I need to put the salt in here. Since this turkey is so smoked, I'm gonna go easy on the salt. I don't know if that was easy enough, but I'm gonna go easy because I can always adjust it. And then once it cooks down some more, I want to taste the flavor in it to see is it tasting the way I want it to. I'm gonna add a little more water in here, probably a cup. And then I need to put my splash of olive oil that I put in everything. Some people put butter in their stuff, but I always put a little olive oil in everything. Because in my head, olive oil makes everything taste better. So I'm going to mix this up. If I need to adjust the seasoning, because you don't have to use my measurements. You can just use what you think is better for you. And then I think I forgot the red flakes. Okay, I added the crushed red peppers, and I'm going to adjust the seasoning if I need to. Might add a little more of something, which I don't know yet what I'm going to have to add, but I'm going to keep stirring it in for a little bit. I might add a little bit more water, just a little, and then I'm going to let it cook for probably about, I'm going to come back in 35 minutes. So I'll be back. Okay, I forgot to put the onions in there, so let me drop some in here. If you was using a real onion, I would use a whole small one or half of a small one, depending on how much onion you want. I need to save some of these onions because I got some pig feet going over there in the other pot. If my pig feet get almost ready in time, I'm going to show y'all those. But I'm finna mix these in, and then I'm going to come back in 30 minutes and just check on
them. Okay, it's been 35 minutes.
And I didn't add any extra water. And only the water that's in here is the water that I started off from that from the smoked turkey neck. Because the greens going to produce water and stuff too as they steaming. So I didn't add anything else. And they looking pretty good. So I'm going to let them continue to cook. And then we'll be back. So I'm just going to stir it around. And then I'm going to probably taste a little bit later. And see do I need to adjust the seasoning any. So I'm just going to let it keep cooking because it's almost there. But they look good and they smell real good. I can smell the smokiness of this turkey. And you can see how the turkey neck just broke all the way down. Because when I boiled it, it was tender and now it's just broke all the way down. So we'll be back. I just sampled a little bit of my greens. I can taste the kick from the red crushed peppers. And I taste the smokiness of the meat. I'm still going to let it cook down a little bit more. And I'm just going to add a little more salt because remember in the beginning, I didn't put as much salt because I was waiting to the end to see what the taste was going to be. And with the collard greens, you have to kind of play around with the taste. So, you know, when they cooking, you just have to keep getting you some out, sampling it to get it to the way you want it because they have a little kick. So if you following my ingredients and you don't want it to be that spicy, you can leave out the crushed red peppers or whatever. You don't have to, or you could just put a little tiny pinch in here. But I added some salt, and I think I'm going to sprinkle just a little more because I can taste the smokiness of the meat in here, and I taste the spice, but I just want a little more salt. And this should be about right. Sometimes, too, I use chicken broth in my greens. Like, sometimes I replace this water with chicken broth, and that tastes real good. Sometimes I put water in here and then put some chicken broth. But it's tasting good. They just need to cook a little bit more because they almost there. But as you can see, that turkey meat then fell all the way off the bone. And if you could hear my little dog in the background barking in this video, I'd probably get at to him because he's sitting around licking his lips, ready to eat. Anything you have, he wants some. So I guess he can look up and get this turkey bone. But it smells good, and I really can taste that turkey. And the more smokiness that you want your meat to have, you just add a little more turkey or smoked turkey or meat to it. I didn't use my whole pack because I had a bigger pack, but I be saving that for some of my beans. But it's coming all the way off the bone, as you can see. So I'm just going to let it cook a little longer, probably about 35 more minutes. And then I'm going to come back because in about at least 30 minutes, this ought to be ready. because it's almost there and this need to keep cooking down a little more. But it's just about ready. So okay, it's been an hour now. So my greens, ooh, they smell good. They are right about ready. So they done cooked for probably about an hour and 45 minutes. I had them on medium high, and then for the last 30, 35, 40 minutes, I had them on kind of low. So they ready, and I'm about to plate them, and then we'll be ready. But I want to show you what I'm making to go along with my greens. I just put some hot sauce in here, so that's why it's like that, some of my pig feet. And if you want to know how I made these, just look on my YouTube and look at my recipe. But it's going to be going down over here because these pig feet are almost ready. I'm letting them cook a little more, but I'm going to be eating real good in just a minute. Here's the ending result. I tasted some, and they taste real, real good. You can taste the smokiness out of the turkey necks. It has a little bit of a kick, and the seasoning is right on point. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, and I'll see you next time.